Hello and welcome to the What Women Want Today podcast. You might be asking yourself right about now, well, what do women want? I mean, we're pretty complex creatures, right? Well, I think we want it all, and I'm here to explore it with you. My name is Terry Kellums. I'm your host. Go grab your favorite beverage. I've already got my glass of wine, and let's get started.
Hello and welcome to this week's episode of the podcast. I am so excited to be here with you today. On the podcast, we have been talking about what the experts say are the six elements to eudaimonic happiness, which is what they consider the most sustainable, lasting kind of happiness. And in episode one, we talked about personal growth and how that impacts our happiness. In episode two, we talked about the importance of your relationships. And in episode three, we touched on self-acceptance and the relationship you have with yourself. So when I came across today's video and recording of an Instagram live I did with Jennifer, who is known as Lemony Connection on Instagram, I thought this fit in really perfectly with what we were talking about in the relationship episode. So that would have been part two of the series. Jennifer and I had a really fun conversation. We started out sharing some cocktails. I am going to put the link to that Instagram live in the show notes today in case you prefer to watch it on video. I mean, we did have some fun. And then we did dive in and we talked about how you can make it safe for someone to be vulnerable in a friendship. We talked about how you can take a virtual friendship and turn it into a meaningful relationship. We talked about our attributes that we seek out when we're looking for someone to be in a close relationship with. And we talked about boundaries and toxic relationships and when you know it's time to kind of walk away from those types of friendships. I hope you enjoy this very vulnerable, fun, and heartfelt conversation between Jennifer and I today. Let's go ahead and join that episode now.
Hi!
There you are.
I'm here. Oh my God, I had to run and get my ice. I'm like, oh, I'm going to miss it somehow.
Oh, no, I had a hard time getting on. It wouldn't let me go live. So you
really?
Had extra 30 seconds.
No. Okay, well, 30 seconds
yeah.
is good.
Yeah, we're good. We're
oh,
good.
Wait, one more thing. Hold on. Because, you know, lighting is so important. Okay.
Yes.
I'm going to flip this on. It just makes it a little brighter. Okay,
I have all sorts of challenges with my location today. Can you see the dead animal hanging above my head?
What? What are you talking about? No, I can't. Oh, is this your husband's?
Yeah. So, I mean, you understand my living situation. So I had to find like a spot where I could like set all my stuff up. And I was like,
right?
I am really out of my comfort zone today, Jennifer.
You know, I had to push you.
Yes. And I'm glad you did because it made me think all sorts of things today.
You did?
Yes.
Okay, good. I have questions.
Good.
A question for you, and I'm so excited about your questions. But
Girl, you want to see my questions?
Yeah.
You're in trouble.
No, I'm. Oh. Okay. Challenge on, sister.
Oh goodness.
Let's do it.
All right, we're ready for this.
No, I'm so excited.
Me too.
We're not actually. You're not a cocktail person?
I'm not a cocktail person. And mostly it's just because I don't like sweet stuff. And
okay.
I think most of them are sweet, aren't they?
But not the one you sent me, girl.
I know.
I haven't tried it yet, but I'm like, okay, I am a cocktail person. Hi, Bev. Oh, hi. You guys, there's so many people here already.
I know. There's so many people here. Hello, everybody.
Yeah,
I'm going to have a hard time keeping track of the comments just because I have the phone a little bit farther away from me today.
Just the one comment, but a bunch of people who are like in to watch us squirm a little bit here because.
I know.
Girl.
It's exciting.
So your cocktail that you sent me is like totally out of my comfort zone. This is like the one that I would not order at the restaurant, but it's savory in a way.
In a way.
Right. Have you tried this one?
So the funny story about that drink is I met a girlfriend of mine in Vegas and we were going to hang out at the pool for the afternoon and neither one of us are day drinkers. And, you know, we're sitting there for a while and it's getting hot and the cocktail waitress is coming around and I said, you know, can we get a menu or what you've got to drink? She hands us cocktail menus and we just kind of looked at each other like, why the hell not? You know?
Yeah,
we're in Vegas.
When in Vegas, you should be drinking.
So they had this drink on the menu, and
when she brought it to me and I tasted it, I said, "Oh my God, this is too strong." And I said to her, "Can I have you make this less strong?" And she said, "You know, in all the time I've been doing this, I don't think I've ever had anybody send me back with a drink
Right,
that
totally.
was
Totally.
too
Well, I what do
strong."
you say? I'm all in because I don't know. Are you a Tito's fan?
You know, I think that that's probably something I would order if I was ordering a vodka drink. I'd probably order Tito's. Yeah. I
Yeah,
don't,
I'm a Tito's
Grey
fan.
Goose. I think Grey Goose was another one I was kind of familiar with. But, you know, the thing about it is it's tough for people like me. You know, here's my sob story. It's tough when you're just basically a wine drinker and then you go to places and they don't have a big selection of wine because I feel like what happens is you kind of become a wine snob over time.
Totally. I
Yeah.
would say I'm the reverse of you in this, which is cool because
Yeah.
I am a cocktail. Stephen and I are cocktail snobs. And so, yeah, we'll be. I mean, I love wine. Don't get me wrong. I like wine. But you like a dry wine, right? And I'm
I
a.
do. I like Sauvignon Blanc. I'm pretty much Pinot Grigio once in a great while if they don't have Sauvignon Blanc. But if they don't, if they have like Chardonnay or something, then like.
Oh, did you cut out? Can you still hear me?
Me.
Yeah, now I can hear you. Okay.
Yeah,
I'm okay.
there we go.
Oh, no. Don't go.
So,
Don't go. Yeah,
are you
we
there?
are. Yeah, can you hear me now? Is it okay? Seems like my signal's okay. Okay. Yeah, we're the complete opposite, which I love this so much because I usually, birds of a feather kind of a thing.
Yeah.
We are birds of a feather in so many ways, we have found out,
We are.
but not this area.
But
It's
then,
fun.
yeah, and then when you go to like an, if you're a vacationer and you are a traveler and you go to like an all-inclusive and they have just like this set menu of drinks they want to serve you, and I'm not really a beer drinker. And so, yeah, sometimes you're just like, well, I don't know what to drink because I don't, yeah. So here we go.
Okay.
So let's
Who's
do
going
this
first?
thing.
Are we doing it at the same time?
Let's do it at the same time.
Okay, well, let me
So,
ask you a question. I don't even, what is
yeah.
it called? Is it called?
I think it's
Name?
called,
What a
what
name?
did I?
I mean,
Let's
I
see
have
if
the
I wrote it
recipe.
down.
You were so nice
Yeah.
you sent it to me, but I don't know what it's called. I'm
I
just
think
assuming it's a cucumber cocktail.
it was called a cucumber lime refresher or something like
Okay,
that. Yeah.
that sounds reasonable because
Yeah.
I have all the stuff, you guys, seriously. So when I read the recipe, it said cucumber juice. Well, I don't know any way to make cucumber juice unless you blend the crap out of it. So I like full on blended it and then I strained it. Okay, let's just see. Let's just see what happens. I have so much ice. Look how classy I am. This is my ice container. You're more classy than I am.
I had like this obsession for a while with like cocktail glasses and martini shakers, and they're all packed away. So
Really?
I just had to make do with what I could find.
Are you looking forward to getting that back out when you finally move?
I am. I'm like,
Okay.
I'm dying for it. Like I once in a while I just go over into the storage area and I just like lovingly look at my boxes of stuff and I touch it like someday.
I've lived like that. I can honestly tell you that it sucks. It
Yes,
sucks.
it
You
does.
want your
It
stuff. You
does.
want your client, your things, right? As a woman,
What
we
is
want
it?
everything.
What is it about that? We get like attached to like things and I'm
I,
not
you know what? I think
judging.
it's
It's
the
just.
idea of like making a home. Like there's something about
Yes.
making a home that just makes me happy. So,
Now, Jennifer, you remember an earlier conversation we had where we talked about if we're rule followers or not? So like I've got out my like measuring cup because I want
You're going exact, like 1 ounce.
2 ounces of this. So mine is simple. You gave me a really simple
I
one, so
did. Well, on
I'm
purpose.
lucky.
Because you said you weren't a cocktail person, so I didn't want to make it all like. But I was glad you gave me a little challenge. I was, okay, cool. Yeah,
So
I'm.
mine is 2 ounces of pineapple, 2 ounces, oh, pineapple, 2 ounces of cranberry, and 2 ounces of, look at this cute little bottle
I love that. I
of
love that.
coconut rum.
Okay, so let me
So,
tell you a funny story about that. So
okay.
that little bottle. So do you remember when Bad Moms, the movie, came out?
Yes, I loved that
Okay.
movie.
So me and a bunch of girlfriends, we decided that we were all headed to the movies and we were all gonna like meet up. And so Jennifer, thinking she's kind of a rebel, not a rule follower, but I am mostly, but I have my moments. I went to a liquor store and I got like a bunch of those little bottles and I thought I was being all like sneaky and like, I shoved them in my purse and then I get there and I'm like handing them down the road to all my girlfriends. And all of a sudden, I swear to you, we start hearing corks popping in the theater because there's all these other women who are true rebels. Jennifer's a fake. They brought in the good stuff, the good guns. So after that, I was like, well, next time I know what to do.
Oh my gosh, that's so funny. That's why you carried the big bag to the movie theater, right? So you can sneak in your own stuff.
Yeah.
Doesn't everybody do that?
I know. Do you guys all do that too? Because I do. I do.
I think everybody does. We're not big movie. Well, I'm not a big movie goer. That's like a little, that should be one of those, you know, those reels that you see where it's like, name something that everybody likes that you're supposed to like, but you don't, or whatever, however it goes.
That's yours?
I'm like, I really don't like to go to the movies. I'd rather stay home and watch a movie on TV.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Are you a Hallmark movie person?
No, I just, Yeah, would rather get my own snacks and pause when I need to pee.
I'm not offended by that. Yeah. I only like movies if it's going to be something romantic or something that makes me cry or, you know, something like that.
A chick flick.
Yeah. I'm a big chick flick person. All right, so you guys, I added this, and I'm going to be honest, it's very earthy because it's all a cucumber. It's, you know. It's a Downs an English cucumber. And then I put in the vodka, simple syrup, and lime juice. And I'm going to add soda water after I
Soda water. Oh, okay. That makes sense.
All right. But we can be all cool. We're like the bartender. Woo!
Okay. It always looks like fun, you know?
It's a good workout for your arms.
Dropping things over here.
All right, I'm going to pour a little of this in, and then I'm going to add my little sparkling water to it and see how I do.
And
I'm going to tell you, I did cheat. I added a little more simple syrup because I am a sweet cocktail person.
Oh, yeah? So, do you like sweet coffee, too?
Yeah.
So I think they kind of go together.
Why do you drink black coffee?
I don't drink black. I just drink it with cream in it. I'm like a latte girl.
Oh, I like a latte.
Yeah. But without flavors. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't mind flavor, but okay. You ready, girl?
So did you tell Steven about this drink? Because you said he likes the more savory
drink. He has like savory drinks. So yes, I did. But he's not going to be home for a while. So I think we'll find out if I, you know. Oh, okay. Okay. I see what you're doing there with your little lime wedge. You're adorable. Okay. Let's see if you like it. How it's sweet. And I'm going to tell you if I like savory. Ready?
All right. Ready? Let's do it.
Okay. That's so bad.
You know, I added a little more cranberry than what was necessary because I thought it would cut down on the sweetness.
Yes.
And I like it.
It's not bad.
I like it.
Here's what I think about this. I feel like it's a garden with some soda. I don't feel the sweetness. There's not enough sweetness in it to make me go, oh, that's a sweet one. It's definitely savory. And a little earthy flavors. I'm not offended by this.
My girlfriend that I was with that day in Vegas, she made it at home and she put Sprite in it instead of the club soda or the sparkling water or whatever. Because
yeah,
she said it made it a little bit more sweet, which she liked.
I could see that.
Yeah.
Well, I did add the simple syrup, so we're on a roll. Mm. We're on a roll for sure. I'm liking this. It's actually really nice.
And I think
it's very warm. So
I think the only thing that would make me like this more is if it was a little bit sparkly.
Oh, like adding a little bit of soda or some of the seltzer, something like that.
Yeah, one of those flavored seltzers maybe. Maybe like the cranberry lime seltzer drinks.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. I could see that being good. Mm. You know, I debated glass or this glass. I wasn't sure what it was. So I went with the tall one because I was thinking about how much stuff had to go in it. Pleased with my decision. So, Mom,
well,
we are on this.
Cheers.
You had a topic. Yes, cheers. I'll totally cheers. Oh, thank you for sharing that with me.
I was thinking about how society like forces this strong label on women. You know, women are strong. We're supposed to be strong all the time. And I think sometimes when women hear that message, they hear, I can't be vulnerable. Mm. And it led me to like this whole thought pattern of we're much stronger as a community of women. We're much stronger in relationship with other women. We need to, it's not just a want, I don't believe. I think it's a need that you need to connect with other females. I think, you know, I know you and your husband are very close. Me and my husband are very close, but there's something about the female connection. And that's sort of the path I was going down with this whole conversation today.
Yeah.
100%. Is we can be strong and still be vulnerable.
Okay. So I'm in on that. I'm totally in on that. But it kind of brings me to something that I was thinking about when I was putting my questions together, because I was thinking about the idea that I have a history in my life of I like having girlfriends, but they have to be safe girlfriends. Does that make sense?
Oh, for sure. Okay. You have to make, and I'm doing a podcast episode about this. I was just writing it this afternoon, writing the outline of it, is, you know, when a woman wants to be vulnerable with you, you have to make it safe for her to be vulnerable.
Yeah.
It's sometimes it's, you know, it's tough when you're just on the phone, but if it's like face to face or even over a camera, there's a body language that you can do. There's, you know, there's the leaning in, there's the listening, you have to make it safe for someone to be vulnerable.
Well, that, and I know that I am, I'll shy away. I don't know how you feel about this. And that was actually one of my questions. Would you ever shy away from a woman, as a friend, because you feel that she's catty or she gossips a lot, or she's just, you know, like one of those people that you feel like, okay, if you're willing to share that about that person, then what are you going to share about me? Would you ever shy away?
I've had this happen actually in the past. Okay. And I'll tell you how I handled it. So I don't not be friends with that person, but I also hold back from that person.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not 100% myself. I'm not 100% comfortable. And when they're choosing to be catty and gossipy, I try to exit. I try to get out of it.
Yeah.
Because I just don't know how that serves anybody.
I'm with you. You know? I think that's the beauty. So you and I, we met in an, I don't even know how we found each other. I don't know. Do you know?
I can't remember either. I was trying to remember that.
Yeah. I don't remember, but we did, you asked me to do a podcast with you and we hit it off. Like it was just an automatic reaction. Like I felt like, oh, I've known you for a long time in my mind. Like, oh, we've been friends forever. Yeah. And so we actually talk on the phone from time to time, just like let things out. Yes. And so the benefit of that for me is what you're talking about in my life. Like, I feel like when we have a conversation that we will like spill things. We'll just spill. Oh, I'm having a hard time with this. I'm dealing with that and going with that. And we know, I have found that with you, I can trust that you're going to hold it together for me. You're going to be like, okay, it's okay. We're not going to share this with the world. That's private information, or that's something that you want to keep. You just want to vent a little bit. So I treasure that. But I don't know if that is a rarity or if that there's a lot of women out there who we could probably confide in. I mean, I think social media, the fact that we met each other on social media and then we formed a friendship, I don't find that shocking anymore. Do you?
No, but I mean, probably 2 years ago, I would have said, what? You know, like,
really?
Yeah, I think so. I think a lot of things happened for me kind of all at the same time. I think, you know, I was going through menopause, which, a lot of the women that I talk to in menopause, they feel bad. Like there's just a lot of changes happening at once. Like, and it's almost a sense of like, you know, my body's betraying me. I'm gaining weight. My skin is saggy. My hair is graying and falling out, whatever. Like we all have our thing, right? That just kind of bugs us about aging. And then, so as that's happening, we move from Phoenix to this little corner of the world and I'm very isolated. Like there aren't a lot of women my age in this area, and it's a retirement community. And then COVID hit. So it was almost like the perfect storm. Right.
Yeah,
and, for my sanity, like for my sanity's sake, I had to find other ways. And, you know, for a while it was the same friends, but, you know, doing Zoom calls or trying to stay in touch. But then I felt like it was falling away because people were just dealing with their own stuff, you know?
Yeah.
And there is a sense that, you know, you don't want to be so vulnerable that you push somebody away, so needy that you push somebody away.
Yeah.
And so I just, you know, I think I just started pouring myself into what I was doing and trying to meet new people online. And I found this very supportive group of women in midlife. And I was thrilled. And I've met, well, you, Bev, my friend Deanna, my other friend, Dina T, the other podcaster ladies I'm friends with, like, and yeah, I talk to all of you on a regular basis. I, you know, it's a supportive give and take relationship. And mm-hmm. yeah, I mean, it kind of leads me to a question I was going to ask you. What are the top three attributes of a great friend?
Oh my gosh, I had a question like that. It's not that, but it's close. Okay, so the top three would actually be, okay, I have to be able to laugh my ass off with a girlfriend.
Yes.
That definitely is a thing for me. If I can be really honest with her, that's another thing. Super honest. Like, you just want to say it. You just want to be like, well, there it is.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
you know that you're not being judged.
Right.
You felt judged. Everybody has felt judged in their life.
Yes.
So that, and then I think another element for me personally is I need girlfriends who are uplifting, that they're not going to allow me to stay in my, like when I'm having a rough time, they're going to hear it, but they're not going to add more to keep me down, but rather right. they're going to encourage me to get back up. And also they're going to speak positive about my marriage with me.
Oh yes. I love that about me and you for sure.
Right. Like yeah. You can hear my shit storms with Steven. Sorry for my language, y'all, but you can hear it, but then you're not going to judge me for it. And,
right.
and you're not going to think tomorrow when I go, he's phenomenal. I just totally adore him. And yeah. his cranky pants is gone. When that happens, you pivot. I had a girlfriend of mine years ago say to me that the best kind of girlfriend is the one that goes with you on whatever emotional roller coaster you're on. So if you're thinking he's awesome, you're thinking that girlfriend's going, he is awesome. If you think he's an asshole, that's what you think he is. That you just go with them where they go.
Yeah.
And that if you stick with that course, you're going to be a good girlfriend. So, and I think that's good advice. What about you? Do you feel the same or?
Well, before I answer you, so I'm seeing so many comments. I see them, but I can't see them. So thank you. Thank you for engaging with us. I wish I could see them better. The camera's just a little farther away from me than normal. But thank you so much for being here with us today. Yeah, I love all of those things. The marriage one is really important because, and I'm going to say this very delicately so I don't throw my friend under the bus, but I do have a friend who was struggling recently. And, you know, I worked through some things with her and her husband, and I'm not a marriage coach, but I am enough of a relationship coach that I can kind of guide some conversations in the right direction. And you know what I feel very strongly about is that I stood up for them in their wedding, and I didn't take that lightly. Mm-hmm. That meant I am a supporter of your marriage. So yeah. if I can do anything to help you guys, like, that's a big deal to me. It's a really, yeah. really big deal. So I don't take that lightly. I think loyalty is a big deal for me.
Mm.
Yeah. And just trust that you aren't, you know, being one way to my face. And the minute yes. I turn my back, you're not putting a knife in it, you know?
Yeah.
Have you ever had to walk away from a friendship because of any of those?
What are you, like, reading my mind? That's one of my questions. Yes, I have. To answer your question, but that is on one of my questions. I'm like, oh, that's one of my questions. I had said, do you ever have to tell a friend you can't be a friend anymore? And the answer to that is, yeah, I had to do that at least once that I can recall in my life. And I have to say that it was the most painful process for me to come up with a boundary in my life that I was willing to say for myself, I'm not doing this. Like, I this relationship is toxic.
Yeah.
And is causing me to be drained in a way that I just couldn't function. Other ones I've just kind of backed away from. Like, yeah. just yeah. kind of slide out of the relationship a little bit.
Yeah, you know that, have you ever had that type of friendship where, you know, they call you only when something's wrong, only when yeah. they need something from you.
Yeah.
And I call it throwing up on you. I mean, they kind of just call you and throw up all over you. And if you want to in any way, like, share something that's going on in your life, well, oh, I'm busy. I got to go.
Right. You know? Right.
And yeah, right. I can think of two off the top of my head. I've walked away from two of those friendships to speak. And not, I felt like it wasn't a selfish thing. Like, I didn't feel like, well, you never want to talk about me. So it was more like, is this really a friendship?
Yeah.
Because friendships go both ways. Like,
It should. You know? But I don't think they all do. And I don't know about you, but I've come to see that I think relationships with girls can be I have several friends who I am just there for them.
Yeah.
And they'll never ask about me.
Yeah.
They don't generally care about me. And then I have some who are very much, they're so sweet. And so they care about me and vice versa.
Mm-hmm.
And the levels of friendship are different too in those. I think, you know, you can have some that are surfacey and then you have some that go in deep.
Oh yeah.
You know, but I think sure. that there can be some, I do believe that there are some friendships that I don't have for myself. I have because I think that person just needs somebody in their life and I'm willing to give that, but I will give a chunk of time and I will go.
Yeah, exactly. Like if you have to prioritize something and they're not prioritizing you, then you're not going to probably prioritize them as well. I mean, you're yes. not. Yeah.
Yeah. I get that. Yeah. Okay. Wait. I got to ask you one. Okay. Are you ready? Did you watch?
I need another drink for this.
Yeah, you do. I would say that to any question though. So, you know. did you watch Friends?
Yes.
Okay. You did. Okay, good. Did you watch Sex and the City?
No.
Okay. All right. Good. I'm glad I had options because I was like, I can't remember. I feel like we had that conversation. But okay. Out of all of the girlfriends that are in the Friends, there's only three, mm-hmm. obviously.
Right.
Which one do you think you're most like? And which one would you like to be friends with if they were real in real life and you had that option?
Gosh. That is so hard. Because I think they purposely made them so different. Like,
right.
I think there's a little bit of Monica in me. Like, obviously, like, I have to, you know, I'm the rule follower. Like,
yeah.
I like things clean. I'm organized. I, you know, there's definitely the Monica in me. I would say I'm least like Rachel because if I remember right, Rachel was like kind of a rich girl. Like, and I didn't come from that kind of background, so I couldn't probably relate to the Rachel character as much. Phoebe, definitely not. No. Phoebe, definitely not. I'm probably somewhere between a Monica and a Rachel on some levels. How about you?
Okay. Wait, but who would you want to hang out with?
Oh, Monica, because she's a good cook. I mean, who wouldn't want to eat that food?
Good answer. I didn't even think about that part of it. That's a really good answer. Yeah. Yeah, for sure. Okay, well, so I'm probably a Rachel because I don't remember her as much being the rich girl as the one who just couldn't ever figure things out entirely and was all over the board at different times and just kind of went with the energy, but she had like passions she wanted to follow. And so she'd go there for a while. And then, you know, she had all these things. So I probably relate most to Rachel, but I'd want to hang out with Phoebe the most.
Yeah.
Because Phoebe is the chillest of the crew and she makes me laugh all the time because she's so bubbly, but she's not really bubbly. You know, like, you know, she's smart and she's so witty. I couldn't stop myself. So yeah, that would be my spot.
That's a good question. Sure. That's a really good question.
Drink was necessary there.
All right. So let's see. What's the worst habit you've ever had to give up?
Oh, hands down. Are you ready for this? You're not.
Yeah.
Do not show Steven this. I swear to God. We cannot let Steven see this ever.
Okay.
My worst habit was trying to control my husband. And then, like, realizing that I was really, I was a nag, and I was trying to get him to do things that would be like me, but I didn't want to marry me.
Right.
I wanted to marry him and all of his differences and all of his, like, he's so crazy. He's so different from me in so many ways, and I was all attracted to that, but then I wanted to make him into me. That's probably by far one of my worst habits that I had to wake up.
It makes so much sense, though. I dated a guy once before I met Brian, and he was so much like me that he kind of annoyed me.
Really?
Oh my gosh. We like all the same things, and it's just annoying after a while. Well,
you know, I was married prior to Steven, and so the relationship taught me a lot. And what I realized as I walked out of that relationship was how very much we were very, you know, we were similar. We were both like able to go deep and we could have heart to hearts. And if I cried, he'd be like right there. Steven's not this guy, by the way. Steven, it's been like training. Like when I cry, you have to hug me. You have, no, you really do. I mean, I'm serious. You have to hug me. So what I found was amusing that we were originally, this is really funny to me, when we first dated, we were in San Francisco and there is a boat that takes you out to Alcatraz Island. And so we decided to get on this boat. And in my prior relationship, I knew exactly what would have happened. You get on the boat, he would have been like, okay, we're going to sit inside by the window because I don't want to get my hair all in the wind and everything. And he would have been very contained. And then when I met Stephen, and we met, by the way, I never went on this with my ex, but when I met Stephen, we decided to do this. So I thought this is a great time to test him. So I did. I said, where do you want to sit on the boat? You can either go inside and we can stay down there, or, you know, we can go to the top of the boat. And he goes, at the front of the boat, at the top of the boat. And I was like, in my head, yes, because yes, he doesn't want to be like, in. I was so happy that he was so excited about that. I actually have come to see that the opposites that attract have a harder time in some ways, but you can also have, you can have both. You can have like things you're in common, like you both want to be adventurous, but you may like, I don't know. I'm just like, as I'm thinking about it right now, I'm like, yeah, I don't know. I think that you really do need to have
some similarities and some differences to make it interesting.
Yeah. All like, we're so alike and we're so in tune. You need like a little rough edge.
Very true.
Yeah, totally. Okay.
Is it your turn? Okay. Yeah. All right.
So we've all had girlfriends now since we were little girls in elementary school, all the way up. How have your relationships with girls changed from being a little girl to now in our midlife?
Oh, wow. That's a great question. It's tough to answer that, Jennifer, because I had my first child when I was a teenager.
Okay.
So I didn't take a normal path, and I feel like I lost a lot of friends when I made that choice in life.
Okay.
Yeah, I grew up in an abusive home, and so like having a baby was kind of my way out of it. And it sounds like a great excuse now, but I didn't take a normal path. So I'm not the girl. I'm the girl who never got to go to prom or homecoming because I was, you know, home taking care of a baby. And I think a lot of girls, and maybe their parents had something to do with it, kind of shied away from being friends with this bad girl that I was. Mm-hmm.
It was a different era back then.
Yeah, it was different. And so then when I did form alliances, you know, with women, I tend to lean towards women who had kids the same age as my daughters were. And yeah. And so now I guess I choose differently because I'm so hungry for a deeper connection than, you know, just watching our kids play at the park together.
Yeah.
Like now I need some stimulation, like some mental stimulation, much more so than I did in my younger years. Like I want to talk about, like, let's talk about marketing strategies for our businesses. Let's talk about what you're struggling with. Can I offer you a resource? Do you have a resource for me? How can we just kind of like do life together and make things easier for each other? And push each other a little bit, you know, I think that's the difference.
You really are like that. I think about the conversations that I've been fortunate enough to have with you, and you are, you're a diver. You'll dive in. You're curious and you have a tendency to like really want to know what that next level is. How could we take that a little bit deeper? I think that's one of my favorite things about having our conversations is that you'll dive into stuff that I'm like, whoa, okay. I didn't know that. And it is so fun to be authentic in that.
Yeah.
That's cool. I'm glad that.
But I also love to be silly. I think we've had some really silly conversations.
We have had some where we're laughing our butts off, which I also think is really, again, that's part of it's a healthy relationship.
Yeah. Yeah. Very good. Very good. Yeah. We are at half an hour.
Okay,
Mom. I usually cut it off about here. Do you have any more on your list that you just are dying to ask?
Let me look.
Yeah, let me look.
Oh, if you didn't watch Sex and the City, which I'm going to have to change that.
Yes, I do.
I have one last question for you. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Have you ever laughed so hard that you spit something out your nose?
Absolutely.
Okay, good.
And so that's what our next goal is. I peed a little too.
Oh, well, heck yeah. Yeah. That's full on. Well, that's midlife, actually.
I love those. Do you guys like to go to comedy shows?
To what?
the comedy clubs.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I haven't done one in years, though.
Like, I love that feeling that you're, like, laughing so much that, like, your side of your face hurts.
Yes, totally, totally. Like, the whole jawline, you can't stop yourself. I love that. You're like, please stop, please stop. Yes.
My kids okay. I have one more question for you.
Okay.
Do you ever get scared in your business when you have to go online? Like, you look so natural and so at ease, and I love watching you. Do you get nervous?
Well, not so much anymore. No, I think now I'm just talking to my friends. That's what I've discovered. Yes. And I say discovered because the very first, if you go back, like if you really go back to the very first one, all I did, I had a glass of wine with me every time I went online because I could not deal with my nerves. Like I was so, oh my gosh, they're going to judge me and everybody's, and now I know everybody's going to judge, but they're also going to support.
Right.
Who cares? Right. Like I'm here. I am who I am. So yeah, it's not as big of a deal. Now it's just my friends.
Well, thank you for joining me today. Brian is probably going to love this more than you do.
Good.
He loves the sweet stuff. Yeah. And yes, let me know if Steven likes it. A funny little story about cocktails with Brian is when we go places, sometimes he'll order a really frou-frou drink and I'll order like a beer or something. Like if it's pizza, I'll order a beer. And they bring the frou-frou drink to me and they bring the beer to him. And then we have to stop.
That's okay. I think we actually have some, we need to go out with our husbands because I think Stephen would be like right on par. We get to the restaurant. Most of the time he'll go after the frou-frou drink too. In fact, martinis were a thing forever in a day. Now it's cocktails. Now it's moved to the bourbon world, but we'll still go back to a lemon drop and a Cosmo anytime somebody wants. So
I love me a good dirty martini.
You like a dirty martini?
I do.
Oh my gosh. Okay. I've only had one that I could handle.
I love olives. It's that salty.
I love olives too. But in my drink, I think I'm going to be always sweet. Although I have to tell you that this one, the closer you get to the bottom, the sweeter it is. So I didn't stir it enough or something.
Oh, well, let me know if he likes it. Cheers, my friend.
Thank you, Mama. It's good to see you.
Talk to you soon.
Okay. Sounds good. Bye, girls.
Hey friend, I hope you enjoyed our time together today and found the information valuable. Remember, you are officially invited to join our Facebook group and private group. I will put the links in today's show notes. If you are interested in exploring coaching, you can email me at Terry, T-E-R-R-I dot Kellums, K-E-L-L-U-M-S at gmail.com or private message me on Facebook or Instagram. If you're enjoying the content of the podcast, remember to share with a friend or on social media. It really does help other women find the podcast. And if you have yet to leave a rating and review, you can do that on your favorite platform. Okay, remember, you are not alone. You are worthy of love and a fulfilled life. Now it's time to go after it.